Hello everyone and welcome to Exploring with Cindy and Dan. Today we're at the Oregon Logging Conference 2023 in Eugene, Oregon. Beautiful day out here. It's a little chilly, but come and join us. This is a great show. I look forward to this show every year. Just a ton of new equipment around here, so we're going to explore this area, let you check it out with us. So we've got this, first up is this little excavator, or this big excavator right here. Log loader type machine. We're here at the John Deere dealer booth. Got a nice little mini excavator here. And actually right behind me, we've got a big old road grader, John Deere. Here's a sign. Now we're back at the little excavator. Here's the specs on the little excavator here, the John Deere 26G. And just off to our left side, we've got a nice little skid steer. John Deere skid steer. It's got joystick controls, really nice machine. Looks like a real comfortable seat. Here's the specs on the skid steer. Here I'm standing on a brand new John Deere log loader. So I'm gonna go take a look in the cab here. Very nice cab. Oh my gosh. Let's get a better look. Nice joystick controls. Looks like a computer. Might as well try out the seat here. Oh wow, very, very comfortable. Looks like the top of the roof here even opens for a little ventilation, has some stereo speakers. All your comforts. Very, very nice log loader. This here is that log loader I was sitting in. It looks like, if you look at the cab here, it has two big brackets. I would imagine this whole cab will tilt forward so you can get to the engine and work on it. Very nice setup. Very nice. Here's the info. So we're going to transition from the John Deere tent. We're going to go over here to the Caterpillar tent. Take a look at the Cat log loaders. Looks like a Cat model 548. I'm kind of curious to see what the cab looks like on the Cat compared to the John Deere, actually. So I think I'll climb in one here. Okay, here we are on top of the John Deere, or excuse me, the Caterpillar log loader. Oh, it's locked. There's a lock on it, but you can still take a look inside. Similar to the John Deere, I can see there's the computer. Very nice piece of equipment. You can see all the log loaders sitting over here. So we're going to take a look at the inside of this Caterpillar cab of this log loader. Another very nice cab. I notice you can see very well out of this cab with all the windows in it. It's very nice. And it also has a sunroof here in the back of it. Right here, it looks like the top opens up for some ventilation. Has your stereo speakers, your vents, heater vents on down here on the floor. Looks like a really comfortable chair. Okay. So I'm standing on a 988K log loader here. It is huge. So I'm gonna go up and check out the cab. The cab is, it's pretty amazing on this machine. Let's go take a look. I mean, this machine is gigantic. Swing around here and see if we can get in the cab. No, the door's locked. There's a nice shot of the log loader cab. Very nice machine. And here's the front portion of the loader. You can get an idea of how big this machine really is when you see the stairs to get on the machine. Look at the stairs here to climb up. Here's the info, the log loader, 988K. This is the big one I was just standing on. It says 541 horsepower. Here's a nice little Cat excavator, model 309. And as you can see, this little guy right here, you can take it home today for $149,500 plus tax. Let's see. And it has a nice little cab on it. So we're back over here at the John Deere area. You can see a nice John Deere log skidder with the logs and the grapple. They have a big old log loader here. Has a debarker machine on the end of the log loader. So you can see that it grabs a tree right there. And it comes out the other end. Cuts the tree, debarks the tree all in one. over here at the Doosan booth. You can see this big excavator with a big bucket. We'll go check out the cab on this machine. And as you can see, all these excavators are computerized now. Nice sunroof. Fan. Let's try out the seat here. Oh, very comfortable. Very, very nice machine. Now we're coming up on a little Kubota area. Nice little Kubota skid steer with tracks. Nice little Kubota excavator here. Many different attachments. We have a little grater blade and a looks like a grinder, stump grinder here. Looks like it's made to go on the front of a skid steer like that one that we just passed up. I notice they're making many more attachments for skid steers. Pretty amazing the things that you can put on the front of one now. Looks like a grapple, pick up logs. We're gonna head over next area. Now we've got the wood carver section. These guys are, they've been here for years. They do amazing carvings here. We got the bear. little portable sawmill here. Here's a really neat little log loader attached to a trailer, remote control. Swing over here, you can see the gentleman operating it with a remote control in his hand there. Here we have a really nice log splitter. Looks like right here, it picks up the log, goes in the machine. And spits them right out the tail end of it. Another little excavator on tracks, a little small one. Here's a nice little unit. Log comes in, cuts it off, splits it, firewood goes right out the chute. This little log splitter is also PTO driven off the tractor. Goes right up the chute and into the trailer. Here's a fairly large skid steer on tracks. Let's take a look at the cab. Here's a little unique skid steer on tracks called the Robomax. I believe this one is remote control. Pretty sure on that. Really nice little unit. Here's a machine called a winch. Timber harvesting. Here's a look at the inside. Cylinders. Here's a nice little excavator. I've never heard of the brand called a Kato, but it looks like a nice little machine. Take a look at the inside of it. Look at all the hydraulics. Here's a little motor, little engine, Yanmar engine here. Has a nice little cab area here. Open cab. Has a thumb right there on the bucket. It's nice.
So you get a nice big screen, you know. This one is for the smaller one, actually, so it's even bigger screen. It's a slightly newer one.
You guys use drones in your work? I'm ready to see.
Here we found some old chainsaws. Look at the bar on these. Man. Some here. 1949. Wood Boss. Here's an interesting saw I have never come across. Called a Mercury. Look at this thing. says it was produced for the U.S. Army during the Korean War, 1951 to 1953, it says here on the tag. Pretty amazing saw. There's another one. Here's a nice old Mack log truck. I'm not sure on the year, but it's a beauty. Really nice and clean on the inside. Looks like there is the lost chicken. Somebody lost their chicken. And there it is. And it looks like his brother's hanging right here. Very, very nice cab. Here are the Link Belt brand log loaders here. Yeah. Looks like some kind of a grinder. Goes on the end of one of these log loaders. Maybe, just from looking at it, looks like it grabs the tree. Just looking on the inside here. Here's a nice log skidder, brand new. Nice seat, looks like it swivels, turns so you can get in. Very easy. Now we're inside the building, as you can see.
So we collect about 60
something. Okay, that much? Yes. So the drone we're getting by the end of the year, it's already built. It's just has to go to the location. That's why I highly recommend this company, because the people you go to. I started off so that's actually a really, really cool thing. This last weekend, I was just flying for
good for you.
Pretty amazing little piece of equipment here. Runs along a cable, has its own little engine. Here's a nice oil station to lube up your equipment. And here's the Cummins booth. You have some nice engines here on display. Let's take a look at this big engine right here. Even found a couple little race cars here at the log and show. Little sprint car. How do your tree jacks work?
It's for timber falling, directional timber falling.
Mm. Okay. What are these run for?
It's about 78. This one's the huge one, so it's about 78,000.
78,000. Huh? So this unit right here, $189,000. There's some really cool wooden toys. I believe they're wooden.
They go in there, and sometimes they go on loader. Sometimes they go on the end of a big loader. Here's a new Chevy mechanics truck. Mechanics truck body, anyway, that is. Silverado 4500 with the Duramax. And there's the price. Thank you.
Here's a cute little machine right here. How handy that would be. Nice little cab. Very nice cab on this little machine. This joystick control. And here's a nice little four-wheel drive Bobcat tractor. And we're now inside the Bobcat booth, as you can see. This is a pretty neat machine. It actually steers, all four wheels actually steer on this machine. Grapple type bucket. And here's a nice skid steer on tracks, a walk behind type machine. I actually have one of these, an older version, and I have to say it is probably one of the handiest machines I think I've ever had. I put a pair of forks on it. And I just lift everything with that machine. Very, very handy. This looks like a little log grapple on the front of this one. These are so nice. This one is MT-100. This one here is made to stand on, right on. Now the one I have is the older version where you walk behind it. Again, very handy machine. There's a log loader, Caterpillar. Here's a nice new Kenworth log truck. 2023, 550 horsepower. And here's a look inside the new Kenworth. Look at the doors on this thing. Oh my gosh. Power seat. Wow, what a cab. Beautiful truck. Amazing interior. Wow. Got a log splitter. here's a Sani brand loader. Take a look at the engine here. It's actually snowing a little bit. Quite an engine, turbocharged. Nice machine. Here's a nice little Sani excavator. It's a little over 50,000. I believe it was about 54,000 with a 5,000 hour warranty. That's pretty nice. Has a nice little cab on it. And the loader that I just previously filmed over here, the Sani loader, is a little over 170,000 for this loader. This about wraps up the 2023 Oregon Log Show. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks again for watching. We thank you for taking the time to watch our videos. We really appreciate it. And please consider subscribing with the notification bell on. Thank you once again.